Hi everyone, welcome to Chinese Pop. My name is Guilin.
Hi, 大家好，欢迎来到中文播客，我是甜心。
Today we have an intermediate lesson, and we're talking about coincidences, bumping into someone that happens to have the same name as you.
不只是跟你有同一个姓，还跟你住在同一个地方呢。
Not only the same surname, but living in the same place.
所以我们今天会学到如何用很礼貌的方式问别人的名字，还有他们住在哪里。
Okay, so lots of polite ways to ask someone their name, and also how to specify exactly where you live.
那我们就赶紧来听听今天的对话。
好的。
请问您贵姓啊？
免贵，姓王，三横一竖王。
我也姓王，你住哪儿啊？
我住长安大街附近，你知道花旗银行不？我家就在银行左边那栋楼。
这么巧，我也住花旗银行左边那栋楼，你住几楼啊？
我住12楼，12A。
怎么可能？我也住12A。这位叔，你不会搞错了吧？
不会，因为我是你爸爸，你这熊孩子，醉到连你爹都不认得了。
Oh my god.
What's wrong?
Look at this, a legal letter. See?They claim that our product name and website infringes on their trademark.
But we have a registered website and a domain name. But did you ever file a trademark?
They are actually demanding that we sign over our domain name.
Did you know that not having a trademark registration is not only important for the brands and trade names you use for your goods and services, but also for your website?Don't risk losing your domain name and social media pages because of a trademark dispute. The Trademarkers Network of Intellectual Property Attorneys can file your trademark reliably and also give you guidance if someone else before you has filed or registered a trademark with your brand. Go to www.trademarkers.com today to make sure you get the brand protection you deserve.
听完今天的对话，诗诗觉得其实不是个巧合。
Yeah, it doesn't seem like a coincidence. It just seems like she's maybe drunk a bit too much alcohol.
对，她太醉了。其实他们本来就住在同一个地方。
Okay, so let's get back to the start of the dialogue where she says, politely, what is your name?
请问您贵姓? This is a very polite way to ask someone,for their name, or specifically their surname. I would encourage everyone to learn this phrase. 请问您贵姓?
And then you would reply, 我姓, and then your surname.
Yes.
In my case, 詹。
或是你可以说必姓詹。您贵姓 is a very polite way to say, what is your surname? And then if you reply with 必姓, you're putting yourself in a humble position too.
Yeah, so the 必 replaces the subject, so you don't need to say 我必。Which I often would do.
是的，你说必姓詹 or 我姓詹。
Now he has also a great way to say, oh, you don't need to be so formal. You can call me 王。
他说免贵姓王。So before I give you the breakdown, I want to give you the feeling of this phrase. So you know when you go to someone's house and you're like, Mr. Rogers. And he goes, oh, no worries, just call me Bob.It's that kind of feeling, but let's break down what those words actually mean. 免是不用的意思。
Okay, so for example, 免费 is like you don't need to use money or
对
fees.
There's no fee. You no need to pay a fee. Or 免税品。
Duty-free items.
没错,就是不用税的东西, right? Items where you don't need tax. 免的意思呢,就是不用。所以不用贵。整句话的意思呢，是说你不用用贵姓来问我姓什么，我姓王，免贵姓王。So you're like, oh, no need for the formalities. I'm just called Mr. Wang.
Now, how does he specify which Wang that is? He describes the character.
That's right. 三横一竖王。
Okay, 三横 3 horizontals, 一竖 1 vertical, 王。
So yeah, so 3 horizontal strokes with 1 vertical stroke, what character does that make?
王。
王没错。
Now, I would probably say 国王的王 like
哎，没错
the王 from king
很好其实中国人呢在介绍自己的名字的时候呢大部分有两个方式第一个呢就是给你这个字出现的其他地方 So the first way is to say another instance where your character would appear For example, with my name 我叫田心田地的田欣赏的欣 So I give an example of where the character appears Another way, especially with surnames, often people describe the character. For example, 我姓陈，耳东陈。So that's the character, we'll put it on the notes, but it's the character with literally the ear radical and then the east, right? 耳东陈。Or another example, 我姓胡，古月胡。The reason for this need to describe the look of the character or how it's formed is often...Characters for surnames don't frequently appear in everyday phrases, right? My surname is quite special because it's Paddyfield, right? So there's lots of examples of that. But if you're a Mr. Chen or you're a Mr. Hu or you're a Mr. Wang, maybe you want to describe how it looks to make sure that people don't get the wrong character.
And if you want to learn more about how to introduce yourself to sound like a native, we've made a Qing Wen about that.Next, she asks him where he lives, and he says he lives nearby City Bank on 长安大街。
对，这位大叔啊，他说他住长安大街附近。你知道花旗银行部 ？Do you know about City Bank?
And this 部 at the if you see a 部 character at the end of a sentence, it indicates a question.
其实在这里有一点点像妈 question particle 这样的一个用途啊，但是是一种口语的说法。你在写信的时候啊，在书写的时候是不会这样写的。
Yeah, it's very colloquial, so you could say 尿咖啡部。
没错，非常好。可以再给我们一个例子吗？
你知道 Chris Nolan 部？
没错，所以当你不想讲你知不知道花旗银行，你可以直接说你知道花旗银行部。It's a very colloquial way to say it. It's great.
Okay, so he's in a building to the left of City Bank.
他说我家就在银行左边那栋楼。
那栋楼 ,dong is the measure word for buildings, 楼 is...
A building, 没错。It's a building as well as a floor, so sometimes you'll hear people say, 哦，我住十楼。但是当他说我住那栋楼,他的意思是那个 building。
Now she says, what a coincidence. How do we say that phrase?
这么巧。巧 is coincidence. 这么巧 What a coincidence, right? 像这么热今天是这么巧
Yeah, so what are the chances? And if you recognize this 巧 character, it's from 巧克力 chocolate.
没错 Gwilym, 你也读爱丁堡大学啊哇这么巧我也读爱丁堡大学
这么巧
So one of those great phrases that I'm sure if you use, you'll crack everyone up. It's like, wow, what a coincidence.
Now she says, I also live there. Which floor do you live on?
她说她住十二楼十二 A. And this is when her mind is blown. 这位小姐啊，她说怎么可能？我也住十二 A. 这位叔，你不会搞错了吧？ Some great phrases in there.
Okay, 这位叔 This 叔 is from 叔叔 like an uncle.
没错 Come on, this older gentleman, right? 这位叔或是你也可以说这位大叔为是让你说话的方式感觉比较礼貌其实今天这位小姐虽然喝得很醉她从头到尾说话的方式都非常的礼貌
Yeah, even though she's quite drunk, she's still using all the correct ways to...talk to her superiors or elders.
这位大姐,这位叔,这位大叔可以帮我个忙吗?
Okay, so it's polite. It's because it sounds slightly rude, like you're talking about them in the third person.
如果你用个这个 measure word 来形容人,你会觉得他好像是个东西。所以大部分的时候,如果要比较礼貌的话,你都会用为来作为一个人的 measure word. 这位叔,你不会搞错了吧?搞错是什么意思呢?
搞错 is a colloquial way to say mistaken or confused.
先生，你是 Jude Law 吗？
你搞错了吧
？Yeah, so when someone's made a mistake, you can say, 你搞错了吧？不好意思，你应该是搞错了。
Now the great reveal where he says, I'm not mistaken, Because I am your father,
I am your father. 因为我是你爸爸。他说你这熊孩子。熊孩子是什么意思呢？
Another great colloquial phrase to mean a little devil or brat.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's quite affectionate. It's not super rude. It's just like, you wild child. 你这熊孩子。
Is this 熊 bear or is this...
没错就是 bear, 因为 bear 很 wild 嘛。
You're so drunk you can't even recognize your father. Number one, what is the word for a father here? It's another colloquial way.
爹。
It's kind of like daddy or father.
爹爹。其实爸爸也很亲切。爹爹更亲切、父亲就比较像是 father.
Now he says you are so drunk you can't even recognize your father.
醉到连你爹都不认得了。
So let's look at the structure. Adjective 到、
醉到喝到唱到。So when you do something to a degree, in this case the highest degree, 醉到连 even, so you're so drunk that even your dad, 你爹都不认得了。Not able to even recognize. 认得 is to recognize. 醉到连你太太都不认得了。
So drunk you couldn't even recognize your wife. So how about a quick summary before we go into the dialogue?
好的，我觉得今天第一个要说的就是那个问别人名字的方式还有自我介绍的方式。先生，小姐，您贵姓？免贵姓？什么 ?whatever, so insert whatever your surname is.免贵姓什么？在今天我们学到王的另一个介绍方式，三横一竖王。
Also, we learned some great colloquial phrases like forming a question with the character 不 at the end.
你知道花旗银行不
？Do you know of Citibank? As well as a way to say you are mistaken.
你搞错了。
And finally, a way to say you little brat.
No, it's not that strong. It's more like
cheeky monkey.
You cheeky monkey, 你这熊孩子。
Okay, well, how about we listen to the dialogue one more time?
好的，那我们就赶紧再来听一遍今天的对话。
好的。
Hey, Tom!
Oh, Tammy, how's it going?
你好，你好。How's your Chinese coming along?
Well, I gave up.
真的吗? Chinese pod no longer?
Well, really, I was so busy, I didn't have the time.
Not the time?You don't have 90 seconds per day.
90 seconds?
Yes, 90 seconds. So you did not try Chinese Pod Recap? This app, you can insert your learning experience whenever you have even just a little window of time.
90 seconds are enough to go through bite-sized pieces and recap your lessons in Chinese Pod Recap, the app for busy learners that want to use little breaks to refresh what they learned.Chinese Pod Recap synchronizes to your phone so you have what's relevant for you available even if you have no internet connectivity. Like on planes or in the deepest tunnels of the New York subway.
请问您贵姓啊？
免贵姓王，三横一竖王。
我也姓王，你住哪儿啊？
我住长安大街附近，你知道花旗银行不？我家就在银行左边那栋楼。
这么巧，我也住花旗银行左边那栋楼。你住几楼啊？
我住十二楼，十二 A。
怎么可能？我也住十二 A。这位叔，你不会搞错了吧？
不会，因为我是你爸爸。你这熊孩子，醉到连你爹都不认得了。
I quite liked how they described the character Wang. I guess because it's such a simple character, it's easy to describe.
感觉有点像一个 fancy way to describe, 对不对？就啊，我姓王，三横一竖王，很酷。我觉得如果你姓王，可以把它学起来。
Could we do it with your name? It's like one square, one horizontal, one vertical.
三横三竖田吗？没有听过这样的说法。
I think I'd spend all day describing mine. I think my character's got like 17 strokes in it.
I mean, that's why some characters with some surnames, you just cite famous people in history. So for example, with you, I would probably say, 我姓詹,詹天佑的詹. But with other surnames that are easier, then you would just describe how they look. 听完今天的对话呢，想提醒各位同学，如果你们有中文名字，其实可以去问问你的中国朋友，会说中文的朋友，帮你写出一个小剧本， So I think it's important if you have a Chinese name to ask a Chinese friend maybe to help you out with a little script of how you could introduce yourself in a more native fashion. 如果你们有听过像我刚刚说的耳东城、古月湖各种不同介绍自己名字的方式呢，你们也可以分享在 comments 里面跟其他的同学交流交流。
Yeah, let us know in the comments how you describe your name when you meet new people. Okay, well, we hope you enjoyed today's class and we'll see you guys next time.
希望你喜欢我们今天的课程，我们下次见，再见。
As usual, ChinesePod provides an extensive selection of learning materials for this lesson on its website, www.chinesepod.com. You can access this lesson directly with the lesson number 4044. So just go to www.chinesepod.com/4044 and you will find a transcript, vocabulary, and much more. The link again, www.chinesepod.com/4044.